There are three ways to become a data analyst. One is you can go to school and earn a degree. Second, you can enroll in a bootcamp, which is basically a condensed degree program, but in a span of few weeks. Third is more on the self-teaching route with the help of online resources. This video, I'm specifically going to be focusing on the third, which is more on the self-taught piece, because a lot of the online degrees and bootcamps already have the curriculum and the structure defined, but it's for the self-taught data analysts that need to figure out what to learn. So this video is specifically targeting towards somebody who wants to become data analyst on their own. And hopefully after watching this video, you'll have a better idea of what you need to study, how you need to approach your learning to become a data analyst. Data analyst job family has been trending for the last few years and it is not slowing down. In fact, I expect the data analyst demand to grow in 2023 as data scientist job family continues to evolve. Based on the last few years of data, an entry-level data analyst in the US makes this much money. And this varies from city to city, obviously. And in my opinion, becoming a data analyst is not that difficult. You need a structure and a roadmap to learn the right skill set to become a data analyst. So in this video, I'm going to share a roadmap on how I would learn data analytics. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the hard skills as well as the soft skills to become a data analyst. Finally, I'm going to be sharing some tips that you can do after you have learned those skill set to get yourself ready for the job. So what does a data analyst do? Data analyst is somebody who helps businesses make data-driven decisions. What does that mean? Well, that means that each company collects a tons amount of data and they need people who can make sense of that data and turn that into information. That's where that data analyst comes in. Now, I will talk about in a different video, what is the difference between a data analyst and a data scientist. So there's at almost every company, there's tons of data that exist, and companies need data analysts to actually look at all the historical performance and inform the business in terms of what's happening and provide recommendation. Basically, in a way, a data analyst's job is to help company make data-driven decisions. And that's why this role is so, so important to any company, because data-driven decision-making is the key. Now, in another video, I will talk about how other data roles play a role when it comes to success of a company in respect to data-driven decision-making, including data scientist, machine learning engineer, data engineer. But in this video, I'm specifically going to be talking about the data analyst role. Before we jump into the roadmap, I always, for any roadmap that I mention, there is always an element of research. So that's exactly what we're going to do as the first step for the data analyst roadmap. We're going to do the research. Where are we going to do the research? Well, how I like to start all my research is if I'm looking at a specific role and I have a company in mind, I like to go to the open jobs for that role. For example, if I want to become a data analyst at Uber, I will go to Uber's site and look up open data analyst role. And then I will read the job description and I will read what are the requirements for data analyst role. That's the first thing I would do. And I would not do it just with just one company. I'll do it with multiple companies and I'll take notes and I'll write it down. So I'm linking a Notion template. If you want to use that while you're researching this, feel free to download it and use it. That's one part of research. The second part of research that I like to do is I like to go on LinkedIn. And I would look at, let's say if there's a target company, Uber, let's take Uber for an example. Uber is what I want to target. I will look at the data analysts who currently work at that company, and I will try to understand what is their educational background and what are they currently doing as a data analyst in that role. What are the type of projects they're doing? And you're going to write this down and we're going to come back to it in the later part. So this part is very, very important. So doing this research actually will give you a really good idea of what you are aiming towards. So you, in a way, you, this is like a backward approach. So I love working backward where I know what is my final result looks like. So I go backward from it. Okay, so you have looked at current data analysts do and what is their educational background. If these people have taken any certifications or a degree program, I'll suggest you to write those down. So far, you know what are the requirements for a data analyst role, specifically the one that you're trying to target. Now, for the next steps, the recommendations, the roadmap that I'm going to give you is somewhat of a general. It's possible what I'm going to suggest is different from your research, so that's where you would kind of tweak your roadmap based off of that. But let's keep going. So once you have done your research, the second part that you will do is you will learn the fundamentals of data analysis, why it's important. And here, what I would recommend is to brush up on basic statistics and math. For statistics, I would recommend to cover probability and hypothesis testing. Again, just have a very intro to intermediate understanding, because you're going to build on this knowledge as you continue building your data analyst skill set. So have a very good understanding of statistics, probability, as well as hypothesis testing. These two are good to cover. For math, have very good understanding of arithmetic and linear algebra. Again, like, I won't put so much emphasis on math, but just having a basic understanding is actually good enough. There are tons of resources available online. There are tons of YouTube channels that are dedicated to teaching you basics in both of these topics, including Khan Academy is a great resource. So definitely check it out. So let's say you have like learned the fundamentals, you have gotten a hang of like what statistics is, like how to use it to apply to data, and how it's used in the business. The next steps you would do is learn the tools. So when it comes to tools for data analysts, you probably should have heard it already. Excel is the bread and butter for data analysts. So I would definitely add that to your toolkit. Learn Excel, learn how to do the basic function in Excel, such as like data cleaning, data sorting, formatting, pivot table, charting, basic visualization in Excel. So those would be some really, really good areas to cover in Excel. The second thing in the tools that I would suggest is to learn one visualization tool. So now we're going to go back to the research part. So in the research part, if you have noticed a certain tool that being mentioned, let's say they were mentioning a lot of Tableau, then that will give you an idea that this is the tool that you need to learn. If you are unsure what tool you need to learn, I would suggest to go with Tableau, because Tableau is, there are a lot of like online learning resources for Tableau, as well as Tableau has a desktop version, which makes it easy to download and start playing around with it. So you should be able to make your reports in Tableau. You should be able to make cool visualizations. Basically, the goal here is that if business stakeholder comes to you and asks you to build a dashboard, you should be able to use Excel and Tableau, one or the other, or combined, to build a beautiful dashboard for your business stakeholders. So get pretty comfortable with these tools, get pretty well-versed in these tools. In my opinion, I can use them in my sleep, Excel specifically. So I'm saying it's not hard, but it might be hard for some of you, but it's pretty straightforward.
Talking about tools that you should learn, creating a website to show your data analyst portfolio is another tool that you should learn. We will talk about data analyst portfolio in a minute. But first, I wanted to share this website hosting tool that I recently started using, Hostinger, who is also sponsoring today's video, where you can basically buy a domain and build a website in less than 3 minutes. Don't believe me? Let me show you. Hostinger is known worldwide for its user-friendly interface and affordable pricing. So it's great for anybody on a budget. They have a variety of plans to choose from. There's 99.9% uptime guaranteed and 30-day money back. Plus 100 GB storage, free email, and website hosting. Premium looks pretty good. I'm gonna click the monthly option. We're gonna make sure to apply the coupon.
Let's select the 12-month option. That looks pretty good. So before you check out, make sure that you apply the coupon code Sundas Khalid. After the coupon code, you will get the 10% discount. So make sure you don't miss that. Click on payment.
Wow, that took less than a minute. Okay, now I'm going to pick a domain.
For my domain, let's check sundaskhalid.com. I've been wanting to get this domain. Let's claim the domain. And ta-da! Looks like it's available and I secured it.
Now let's build a website with Hostinger Website Builder. Let's pick a template and start building our data analyst portfolio.
This is hands down my favorite step in website building, which is to pick a template and start building the website. Let's pick a template for the domain that we just bought. I really like the black one that we saw here. Yeah, this one. So let's pick this one. And as you can see, it's super easy to make edits and make changes. Here, for example, I'm updating my name. And wow, it is this simple.
Did you see that took less than 3 minutes? In today's job market, having a website portfolio can help you stand out among recruiters and hiring managers. And Hostinger is one of the great options for anybody on a budget and looking for a user-friendly, reliable option. You can find the link to Hostinger in the description below, as well as the coupon code. All right, now back to the video.
So let's say you've learned the tools. By now, you have learned the fundamentals. You have learned the tools. You know how to use Excel. You know how to use Tableau. Now, this is the third step. The third step is you will start learning how to code. So for coding, what I would recommend you to start with and become pretty good at is SQL. SQL, 90% of the time, you're going to be using SQL. And maybe 10 or 5% of the time, you might be using Python. So what I would recommend here is that become pretty good with SQL. Know how to do the join joins, know how to do the Windows analytics functions, know how to do queries, subquery, temporary tables, and all that sort of thing. So you should have an intermediate knowledge of SQL. And for Python, what I would suggest you to focus is don't go too deep into it, but go deep enough that you're able to use the data analysis libraries such as Pandas, NumPy, and you're able to like load your data and do a basic group by. One of the best things, if you know SQL and you're moving to Python for data analysis, try to turn your SQL group bys or SQL algorithm, SQL logic into Python. I have personally found it to be pretty intuitive when learning going from SQL to Python. So these are the two languages you learn. So by now, you have basic understanding of stats, math. You have good understanding of using Excel tools such as Excel and Tableau, and you know SQL, Python. The last part, which I would mention here, is the soft skills. So far, you've learned all the hard skills, which are super, super important for the role, but all of those things are not useful if you are not good at communicating and storytelling. Communication is super, super important for a data analyst because you're going to be working with business stakeholders, with product managers, and any other key stakeholder. You're going to have to communicate with them at the start, at the middle, at the end, and throughout the project. At the start, you're going to be asking the right set of questions to make sure that you're understanding the problem and giving a solution. So how does the communication and storytelling happen? In business, most of the times, communication and storytelling take place in form of presentation, in form of documentation, in form of emails. So get a lot of practice of doing all those things where you are able to explain your ideas and tell a story that other stakeholders are able to understand. How do you become better at communication? How do you become better at storytelling? One way to become better at communication and storytelling is by doing it. You can practice it by writing about your projects, writing blogs, participating in public speaking, or just telling your friends and family members about something that you did and pretend that they are the business stakeholder, then you're explaining it to them. You can do that over and over again and eventually get better at it. So let's say you build your communication and storytelling. So far, you know the fundamentals, you know the tools, you know the coding, you are getting better at communication and storytelling. Now you're gonna start building your project. Once you have done all the skill set, you've done the learning, you need to start building your project portfolio. And here, remember the first step that we did where we research into what data analysts that currently work at your target company are doing. That gives you a good idea what kind of projects that you need to work on. It could be as simple as you looking at your credit card purchases and summarizing it and visualizing it, or it could be specific to the domain that you're targeting. Let's say if Uber is your target company, then in this case, you will make up data of like Uber rides and try to like solve a problem with that data and create a dashboard and visualization. So have at least like 4 to 5 projects that you can add to your resume, because those projects are going to help you get attention of the recruiters. I will definitely cover the project ideas in a different video because I have a lot, but basically the whole idea of building projects is to get practical knowledge, because by watching the tutorials, you're not going to learn. It's going to be really hard to run into all the real life problems that you'll run into while doing the actual work. So by doing, you actually learn it. So building project portfolio is going to help you learn better. And these are going to be the projects that you're going to be talking in your interview. All right. So let's say you have built your project portfolio. You're not done yet. We have to do one more step, because I'm assuming that you're learning data, you're trying to become a data analyst is because you want to get a job. So the last thing I would do is I would start interview prepping. Interview prep, knowing the skills and going into interview setting is completely different things. To be able to sit down in an interview and answer a question in a time-constrained setting is very different. You may be able to solve a problem in 30 minutes, but an interview is going to require you to solve that problem in 5 minutes. That's why you need to get better, more and more practice of solving coding problems as well as other data analysis case questions that you can do. For your SQL and Python, you can try platform like LeetCode and Strata Scratch. For your case studies, there are like tons of case studies that I personally use from Analytics Vidya. They have a tons of case study on data analysts. Again, like the interview format and the structure and the type of questions would be different from company to company. So here you'll do your research again and try to understand what is being asked, and you'll figure out what to prepare on. But last thing I would say on the interview prep is do the mock interviews, because mock interviews is going to help you identify your gap, your weaknesses, and you're going to reiterate in before you go into the actual interview and basically have that conversation. Well, hopefully this video gives you a better understanding and a roadmap of how to learn and become a data analyst. Let me know in comments your thoughts. With that, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in another video. Have a good one. Bye.